Can't believe that May the 4th be with you passed by, and I didn't make a LEGO Star Wars video on that day. Just my luck. It was one of the days that I wouldn't record. Hey everybody, it's the MechMaster 14. Welcome back to more LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. In the last episode, we started doing some of the mini-kit bonus levels. Well, not necessarily entirely mini-kit, but also some of the character bonus levels. In this episode, we're going to be finishing up with those bonus levels and starting to get to the actually good ones. So let's get playing. Alright, we made it up to A New Hope last time. We gotta get... Alright, Mos Eisley character bonus. That's going to be Anakin Skywalker's ghost. I want to get through these as quickly as possible, and I feel like playing as the ghost characters and not getting attacked for the most part would probably be the easiest way. And of course, for those of you who didn't see the last bonus video, in these levels, we're not allowed to have Sword Times 2 or Stud Magnet active. I'm not certain about the Stud Magnet, but I just assume so. Yeah, it's very handy when the enemies are only trying to kill our partner. You can go ahead and after him, I'm just trying to get the money. Hey, a beach trooper! And I think we might have to switch to a fountain. Alright, yeah, these things, the bow upable things have some good loot in them. I feel like I most definitely missed some purple studs, but whatever. I just blow this up. And also, everything that we're blowing up, it does respawn, so you don't have to worry about not being able to find anything, because if you can't find anything new that you need to blow up, you're probably going to find something like... Oh, we have power walls. Alright, let's get that bounty hunter again. Because we get a ton of money from these. Wow. That was like 200,000 from one set of stuff. Set of stuff, that's very good English. Where is there more stuff? There's more over here. I think there's more up this way. And also, I'm doing so good at these levels because, well, I run around and collect money. That's my thing. So obviously I'm going to absolutely crush all these records. I mean, we're not even gonna make it to 4 minutes. Hopefully. Because I said that, I'm probably never gonna find anything else that actually is gonna take us 4 minutes. Alright, bounty hunter. I think I just killed that. Alright, there we go. I really should have been blowing up the metal things more, because that gives you like 5 purple studs. Alright, nice. We're almost up to 130 gold bricks, which is the number of gold bricks you need to complete the Clone Wars game. By the way, if you want me to do a Let's Play on LEGO Star Wars The Clone Wars, I might actually... I might actually do it at some point. Obviously not going to, it's obviously going to be in the distant future, like not the near future. But if you want me to do it, I'll definitely do it at some point. Next up is Minikit Bonus, and we're going to be doing it on the Death Star, so... How about we do it as a TIE Fighter? TIE Advance, sure, why not? I really hate it how most of the ships that are actually good at this are ships that we can already play as, like the TIE Fighter. Yes, already got a power. Well, at least we're 100,000 studs richer. Not sure what we're gonna do with it, though. Actually, what am I talking about? There's still powers that we need to purchase, like score times four. Not sure what we're gonna do with that, but whatever. Well, then we need to use score times four to get score times six, then you need to use that to get score times eight, then score times 10, and then after that, we're just gonna have a bunch of money that we can't really do anything with. It's a vicious circle. Alright, well, that's the entirety of A New Hope done. So now it's time for Empire Strikes Back. Minikit Bonus, this is on Bespin. So we're gonna play as Ben Kenobi Ghost. And honestly, for these missions, I'm not really gonna play as the Yoda Ghost. Because Ghost Yoda is actually really slow and... If we play as him, we're probably not gonna get, be able to complete these. Oh yeah, power orb right off the bat. And starting things off, we're going to have to, access all these different areas by opening these bridges. Alright, bet there's some good stuff in here if it's locked behind like a bounty hunter thing. Ow. Oh, I didn't even blow it up and I died. Power orb, nice. Oh wait, there it is. Thank you. Now we need to switch back to the ghost guy. I honestly don't think going into those metal things is worth it. Nothing in here? Oh, come on. I'm gonna be honest, I remember this level being harder than some of the others. Luckily, our partner is invincible and can't die. Also, this place is not very safe. Only the very edges of these platforms have guardrails on it. Like, these are lawsuits in the making, guys. I feel like I should probably attack these guys. Okay, they don't really give a whole lot of money. Actually, they kind of do. I will attack some of them, but we gotta prioritize money over everything else. I mean, we use the force of these things instantly, so we might as well do that as well. And we're actually a little behind target. Because we're not at 500,000 and we're halfway there. Alright, we gotta find more power orbs. And I'm pretty sure we just cycled back to where we started, which means there's a power orb somewhere, right? Yes, we needed this. Yes, another power orb. Blow all these guys up. Alright, I think we're right on target now. But we gotta move fast. Kill these guys. I love the range on the Super Jedi Slam. It makes getting studs a lot easier. So close, I don't have to redo this. Alright, purple stud, yes. Alright, we're so close, but we just have 15 more seconds. Alright, we're gonna get this. And just power over for good measure. Alright, that was unnecessarily close. I did not enjoy that. I mean, I knew Bespin was going to be tougher than some of the other levels, but that was tough. We were less than 8 seconds off of failing. But hey, that's another gold brick. No, I do not want to restart that. That was not enjoyable. Maybe if I blew up more of those metal things, I probably would have done better, but hey, I passed. And now we have to go back in here for the minikit thing, which is on Hoth. And what better to do it on Hoth with than the AT-AT Walker? You're gonna see why this is a bad idea in a few seconds. Yeah, that walker is incredibly slow, so if you do a level entirely as him, you're not going to do very good. Which is why we need to switch to something else. Purely other than real stuff, yeah. turn on invincibility. I really didn't want to have to use it again, but it's so useful here. The explosion like cut through something, so I thought it was supposed to be out. Well, we're well past starting and we haven't gotten any power rolls yet. We are from like one of the hardest missions to one of the easiest missions. That's always cool. Should be probe droid. We saw that in the Hoth battle. Yes, power orb, got it just in time. We only have to do the Return of the Jedi missions now, and then we can actually start doing the fun ones that are in the other room. Mostly fun, I should say, because I do remember some of those levels in the other room not being very fun. Alrighty. So, they're both on Endor. I guess they ran out of ideas. I mean, they could have had one in Jabba's palace or something. Like, they could have had the character bonus in Jabba's palace, or maybe the mini-kit bonus in the Great Pit of Carcoon, which, again, should have just been called Pit of the Sarlacc. Seriously, they ran out of ideas here. Lazy. Also, I guess they're not attacking us? Yeah, even though they just saw a bunch of stuff get destroyed and take damage, they're not attacking. Yes, Power Orb! Alright, this should hopefully be a very easy mini-kit level. And actually, kind of closely resembles the Ewok treehouse. Not really, but sort of. Yeah, we're already almost halfway done and we just started. I feel like I did that in all these levels and then we just barely make it. Actually, no, we don't. The mini-kit bonus in Empire Strikes Back, not the mini-kit, the character bonus level in Empire Strikes Back, that was the one where we got closest to failing by far. And again, none of these guys are questioning the fact that they just saw a bunch of their comrades get destroyed. And also, where are these red guys coming from? They're supposed to be Imperial guards. They're supposed to be guarding the Empire. Although, given all the Empire's power, I really don't see why he's someone who needs to be guarded. And again, look how good they are at not questioning what they just saw happen. A ton of your friends just got annihilated, and you're not trying to question it at all. I mean, hey, at least we can cause mass genocide without any repercussions for now. There we go. There we go, that was not hard at all. It's good because of how hard the last character bonus was. I'm in for a good evening. Okay, just one more of these bonus levels left, then we can probably end the video off because these are taking a long time. There we go, now let's head to the minikit bonus, which is also on Endor. And I really want to play as Jabba's sail barge, but it's just not that fast. It's an awesome ship, just like the Star Destroyer, but unfortunately, just like the Star Destroyer, it's really slow. Also, I didn't get to show it because it actually slipped my mind. Yes, we finished exactly on the second. That's awesome. Anyways, what I was saying, it kind of slipped my mind. We also could have played as a Droidica, which is an actual character. But that's not really recommended since it's really slow, just like the AT-AT. And it's also tiny as hell. You can't really see it. Anyways, that is all the stud bonus levels. So next time on LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga, we're going to be heading on to the actual good bonus levels, some of which are good, in this area. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you can, like, comment, and subscribe, because that really help out the channel. And I'll see you guys next time. McMaster, out. Don't be ready.